far, Mark DeCarlo has won cash and prizes totaling $64,038. Today, one of our contestants could win a gold necklace, a large screen TV, a 35-millimeter camera, or a trip to Aruba, and continue a journey towards a fortune in cash and prizes, including the Toyota Celica, and $50,000 in cash. In total, over $100,000 on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Perry.
Thank you very much. Good to have you here. Delighted to have you here. Well, I hope you had a nice Easter holiday. I know it had to be a nerve-wracking time for our champion, even though he had that sign. I hope you caught it. Say, Mom and Dad, relax. He's got to be a little nervous. A fine champion, Mark DeCarlo. Hello, Mark.
Hi, Jim. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing okay. If I'd just like to say hello to all my family back in Chicago. They talked to my mom over the weekend, and she was a little bit nervous. So.
Well, yeah, if people haven't been with us, there's a good reason for that, because Mark DeCarlo cleared the entire winner's board. He's got thousands and thousands of dollars worth of prizes. On this show, he is risking it all to try to add a $50,000 cash jackpot. Very simply, it's all or nothing for over $100,000 today for Mark. I can only wish you good luck, Mark. You're a fine, fine champion.
Thank you, Jim.
Here to introduce the challengers, Summer Bartholomew. Hello there, Summer.
Let's introduce
this
contestant. Yes. This contestant is a diligent house sitter originally from Fairlawn, New Jersey. Help welcome Deborah Opendale.
Hello there, Deborah.
This next contestant is indebted to a going program originally from New York City, New York. Let's greet Howard Schechter.
Hello there, Howard. See you a little bit later. Summer was trying to make it so sure she got your name right here. It's Schechter, right, Howard?
Schechter,
that's right.
Right.
Howard Schechter. Indebted to your own program.
That's right, Jim. I felt my beautiful daughter could be doing a little better in school, so I put her on a financial incentive program, and at the end of the first marking period, she had me in debt for almost $300.
Works?
Yes,
works.
It works.
Good to have you here. You gotta share that with me. Deborah, a diligent house sitter.
That's right, Jim. I babysat my friend's apartment, and when she came back, every part of me turned green except my thumb, when I found out I had watered her plastic plant for 2 weeks.
Did it grow?
I thought so.
Good to have you here.
I thought it looked better.
I think it did. Certainly it looked cleaner, right?
Yes.
$20, that's all three players off, and this very important game starts with this question. What do we call a closed plane curve of 360 degrees?
Howard. Circle.
Circle is right. First five on the plus side goes to Howard. He goes to 25. With which of the performing arts do you identify Renata Scotto and Placido? Deborah.
Opera.
And Placido Domingo is going to say singing opera. You're right for five, and you go to 25. Deborah's fan club is heard from out there. Wayne Winston Churchill held up two fingers in this. Deborah?
Victory.
That's right. V for victory is exactly. Victory is what we wanted. Good anticipation. Deborah goes to 30. According to the old saying, you should never look a gift horse. Deborah?
In the mouth.
Exactly, and Deborah with three in a row to 35 and a $15 lead over Mark. What would a chef reach for if a recipe called for sodium chloride? Deborah?
Salt.
Sodium chloride is indeed salt, and Deborah hits the $40 mark. Well, Deborah, time for an instant bargain, of course. Player in the lead can buy bargain merchandise. Sale surprise with a cash bonus could come up. Deborah, right away, you've got a big lead. You've got a $15 lead over Howard. You've got a $20 lead over Mark. Can we interest you? Oh, this is nice, Deb.
Deborah, to make your cooking easier, here's Frigidaire's mid-sized microwave oven, featuring touch control, a meal minder probe, and the full circle cooking system, furnished by Frigidaire. It's normally priced at $340, and today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $5.
Lovely. Very lovely.
That's very nice.
That's a what, Mark?
That's very nice.
Isn't that nice? Mark thinks you... Mark likes that for you. I bet Howard does, too.
Yeah, I think so.
And Deborah, $340 it would normally cost. Good microwave. I mean, you...
That's very tempting.
Yeah, that's right. Just don't put plastic plants in there. That's all.
Oh, then I don't need it.
$5 it would cost... Well, if you don't need it, then I guess I'd be wasting my time to ask you if you wanted to take... $200 in cash with it. $540 bargain for just the value of one question.
That's sounding a lot better.
Going once, going twice. She likes the microwave. Enjoy the microwave and the cash. cost you just $5, and you still have the lead. The $10 lead over Howard, $15 lead over the champion. How many corners are there in a cube, Bart?
Four.
Nope. Eight. In a cube, there are eight. Champion loses five for the incorrect answer, down to 15. What do we call the type of multi-family housing in which individuals, Mark?
Co-op.
Co-op or condominium, they own their own shares, yes. Yeah. Champion gets one on the plus side, he goes to 20. Mark's fan club breathes a little easier now. Back to the $20 mark. What is the title of the Shakespearean play in which Petruchio wooes Howard?
Taming of the Shrew.
Weds and tames Catherine, you are right. Taming the Shrew it is, and Howard goes to 30. Yeah. Oh, a very important game, and every dollar up there on the fame game board might be the difference. Playing now for a pick of that board, looking for a famous person. I am a show business legend, born in Connecticut. My career began in 1835, when I exhibited an aged woman who claimed to have been George Howard.
P.T. Barnum.
George Washington's nurse, you are right. P.T. Barnum it is. With very limited information, nine numbers up there, Howard. What one do you want to pick?
Number nine.
And behind number nine, we have $600 in cash.
Okay. $600 goes into your pocket. Yours to keep no matter how you finish in the game. So a good first segment for the challengers. As Howard's got $600, Deborah's got $200 and a microwave, and the champion is going for over $100,000. We'll be back.
If you live in Los Angeles or are planning to visit the L.A. area and would like to become a contestant on Sale of the Century, call area code 213-557-3555. And now back to Jim Perry and Sale of the Century.
And back to a very important game with Mark DeCarlo and an all-or-nothing bid for over $100,000 in cash and prizes. And he is trailing right now. It is Deborah in the lead at 35, Howard at 30, the champion at 20. From which country did the United States purchase Louisiana? Howard.
France.
France is right, and Howard ties Deborah for first place. And the old song, Oh, Susanna, from what state did I come, Mark?
Alabama.
Well, with a banjo on my knee, that's what it is, Alabama. And Mark closes the big $10 of the leader. In printing, what word does the ampersand, Mark?
Asterisk.
No, sorry. It stands for and. A-N-D. The ampersand stands for and. And again, the champion loses five. Five American presidents graduated from the same Eastern University. Mark?
Princeton.
No. Harvard. Harvard. John Adams, John Quincy Adams, Roosevelt, two Roosevelts, and Kennedy. And the champion back to 15. Instant bargain. Howard and Deborah, you're in a tie. Only one of you can have this. When you hear the low sale of the century price, hit your buzzer. Oh, one of you might enjoy this.
Here's a trip to Catalina Island. You'll take the cruise boat from San Pedro for 3 days in Avalon, a friendly little seaside town where just about everybody has time to say hello. This relaxing trip is normally priced at $681. And today on sale this century, it's yours for only $10.
Well, that's nice. Howard, Deborah, no one's hitting the buzzer. Cruise to Avalon. I'd love for one of you to have it.
I love Catalina. It's beautiful.
Cost you only $10.
That's all?
That's all.
And you love cruising, right?
No, I get sick on that cruise. Oh. You should take it.
$100 in cash.
$100,000 in cash? You could use the money.
$200 in cash.
$200.
Deborah know. Howard, more and more, said somebody. I'd love for one. $300 in cash.
$300,000.
For $10. Mark is signaling more and more. Well, Mark's going for a lot. $500 in cash. Ooh. For $10. Going once. Going twice. Howard and I. Oh, he fooled Deborah. He decided to go for it. Howard is so surprised as well. Way to go.
Oh, come on. No.
Howard, you got $500 in cash, a $681. This is heavy. This is
a lot.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, $1,000 in cash. $1,500 in cash and a $681 trip for the value of two questions. What a great buy that was. We knocked the $10 off your score. That's all it cost you. Deborah, now how do you feel about that trip?
Delighted.
Okay. Back to business. Founded in 1688, this insurance company has covered the Titanic. Howard?
Lloyd's of London.
That's exactly what it is. Howard gets five of the $10 right back. President Reagan and Canadian Prime Minister Mulroney teamed up to sing When Irish Eyes Are Smiling to commemorate what?
St. Patrick's Day.
That's when they did it. Yes, indeed. Mark, back to the $20 mark. This mountain, the tallest in Greece, was once thought to be the home of the gods.
Mark? Olympia.
Get it?
Mount Olympus.
What? Yes, all right, my judge said we'll accept that. Yes, indeed, you've got another 5 to 25. In 1969, who was wed to John Lennon? Deborah.
Yoko Ono.
Yoko Ono it is. Deborah first for the buzzer. All three players going for that buzzer. She's at 40. Name the handsome star of Magnum P.I.
Tom Selleck.
Tom Selleck is right in the check. He'll be powered with the buzzer. And goes to 30. Yeah. I don't know if you read it recently, but the highest paid TV star in a series, Tom Selleck, Magnum P.I., he makes $4.8 million a year. Of course, the rock star Prince earned $17.8 million for his album Purple Rain alone. I'm in the wrong business. I gotta. You watch this commercial. Well, since my baby left me, I'm gonna crack it. I'm gonna be late. In this very important match right now, Mark fails by $10. Deborah's in the lead at 40. Mark and Howard both at 30. $10, $15 money cards up there. We're looking for a famous thing. I was first copyrighted in 1935. And have since become one of the most popular competitions of any kind in the world. When I was originally offered to Parker Brothers, they took Mark.
Monopoly.
You are right. That's exactly what it is. Took a chance. It pays off with a pick of the board. And now with a very important pick of the board, Mark, what number do you want?
Gotta be lucky today. Number 2.
And behind number 2, we have Mystery Money. Your pick again.
Mark, you picked up a lot of cash up there with that Mystery Money, but you are going for a lot right now.
7.
What?
7.
And behind number 7, we have a laundry center. Frigidaire's Skinny Mini Laundry Center, a family-sized washer and dryer in one compact cabinet with water miser control and flowing heat-drying system. Furnished by Frigidaire.
Well, it's a great price. It is $750 worth of washer and dryer, but obviously it was not what Mark was looking for. He was looking for money cards. They will stay up there. I'll add a $25 money card a little bit later on. Back with this for all three of you. Until 1980, Zimbabwe, a nation in southern Africa, was known as... Howard.
Belgian Congo?
Nope. Rhodesia, or southern Rhodesia. Either one acceptable, you lose 5. Took a chance that did not pay off. In English, this word of Latin derivation means horn of plenty. What?
Cornucopia.
Cornucopia is exactly what it is, and Mark pulls it within 5 of Deborah. Head, heart, hands, and health are areas of development for what young people's organization? What?
Boys Clubs of America.
Nope. Head, heart, hands, health... 4-H clubs, 4-H clubs. Again, Mark takes a backward step. $10 lead for Deborah. Deborah, great opportunity again to buy. Instant bargain. You have a $10 lead.
Mm-hmm.
How about this?
Deborah, for those times you want to kick up your feet, here's the getaway chair, computerized massage lounger with a built-in AM/FM stereo cassette with wraparound speakers. It's designed for total relaxation, furnished by HWE Incorporated, and it's normally priced at $1,495. And today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $15.
Very nice. Very unusual. It's a lovely... Do you like the chair?
I like it very much.
Okay, $1,495. Now, Howard just made a lot of money with an instant bargain. Who knows? Another sales surprise, never know. Mark is going for a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to do two things. Right. I'm going to give him a sporting chance at the money he's going for and give you a sporting chance because you would be in a tie. I'll give you the chair, mm-hmm. not for $15, but for $10. You'd be in a tie with Mark. And if you bought the chair for $10... I would give you $1,000 in cash.
That's real money.
You'll be in a tie to the champion.
Gotcha. Yeah. That's real money.
Going once, going twice, we've got a tie. We'll be back. Enjoy. Mark DeCarlo going for over $100,000. The scoreboard tells it all. It is Deborah and Mark at 30. Howard trails by just one question at 25. In the Bible, King David had a son who became... Howard?
Solomon.
We've got a three-way tie. You are exactly right. What is the capital of Pennsylvania? Mark?
Pittsburgh.
Oh. Harrisburg. Harrisburg. You lose 5. Down to 25. The book Wired is a controversial, Howard.
John Belushi.
Biography of what comedian? John Belushi it is, and Howard goes into the lead now at 35. Bouncing around. $10 separate the players, and as promised, the $25 money card is up on the board right now. Don't shout out an answer, please. Famous person. I was born in Massachusetts in 1735 and died July 4th, 1826. I graduated from Harvard and became a lawyer. I took a leading role in opposing British colonial policies, and the Stamp Act proved a turning point in my life. I helped draft and was a signer of the Declaration of Independence. As the second president of the U.S., Mark?
John Adams.
Yes! That's right. Mark?
I almost said Jefferson. I'm glad I said Adams. Okay, $25 money card is behind number five.
And behind number five, we have a food preparer. This KitchenAid mixer with attachments can handle most every task, from the single egg white and eating yeast dough. It's a complete food preparer furnished by KitchenAid.
Where were those big money cards?
Behind the number six, the number four, and the number three.
Number three and number three. Well, we finish up the game with a speed round. 60 seconds on the clock, please. Mark has been brilliant in the speed round, and he better be now, because he is trailing. Howard at 35, Deborah at 30, Mark at 25. We start the speed round now. Who was Sherlock Holmes' faithful companion? Howard?
Mr.
Fine. Name Johnny Carson's regular band leader. Mark?
Doc Severinsen.
Right. In Peter Pan, who was the villainous captain? Deborah?
Hook.
Right. To Granddad, what was a Pierce arrow? Howard.
Car.
Right. What part of your body would you place in the care of an orthodontist? Deborah.
Your teeth.
Right. What type of vegetable is a scallion?
Mark. Onion.
Right. In the song, what color ribbon was tied around?
Mark. Yellow.
Right. During the Battle of Trenton, what river did George Washington? Howard.
Delaware.
Right. Who wrote the beloved holiday songs White Christmas and Mark?
Irving Berlin.
Right. What number is represented by the Roman numeral M? Deborah.
Thousand.
Right. In what holy city would you find the Wailing Wall?
Jerusalem.
Right. Name the English poet and novelist who wrote Gunga Din. Deborah.
Kipling.
Right. What do you collect if you're a philatelist?
Mark. Stamps.
Right. What's the term for a poem containing only 14 marks? Time. You lose five. Name the commit. Time is up. We've got a tie. We have a tie. Howard, you are out of it. You cannot answer. It is between Deborah and Mark. Remember, if you answer incorrectly, you lose five. You would lose. Answer correctly, you add five, and you would win. An Indian woman named Sacagawea led Deborah.
Pocahontas.
No! She led Lewis and You've got a cruise to Mexico, which you wanted, right?
Yes.
Yes, another lovely thing. Beautiful stereo system. You got a couple of stereo systems.
Those, yeah.
Sports car. I know you were eyeing.
Yeah,
you got a great sports car.
It's going to be a real bad thing to give up the 78 Malibu, but
well, you've
got to do it.
$3,000 in cash you've got, $10,000 in cash off the board, and now you've added $50,000 with all the other prizes. He even got a new shirt, as a matter of fact. His roommate back there said he can keep the shirt that he borrowed to come on the show, which I think is very nice of the roommate. Well, Mark, now listen, there's one other thing.
Oh, no.
You can come back one more time and risk all of this and own the show.
No.
Well, in that case, you're going to have to say goodbye, and Mark DeCarlo is going to say goodbye with And congratulations. You took a great risk. It has paid off. We are all very proud of you.
I had a great time, Jim. Everyone on the show is great. Angela, Lisa, everybody connected at the show.
You're sensational. We wish you well.
Are you okay, Ma? Are you sitting down?
We wish you well with your theatrical ambitions as well.
Thank you very much.
Mark DeCarlo leaves us with $115,200.
Studio audience is under funny business. Jim Perry's wardrobe furnished by Botany 500. Summer Bartholomew's wardrobe furnished by Two Potatoes. All prices are manufacturer's suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. This is Jay Stewart speaking.
Tonight, it's an all-new TV's bloopers. Jerry Mathers proves that the Beaver is still breaking him up. And there's an Olympic-sized practical joke on gymnast Kathy Rigby. Then Richard Chamberlain stars in the saga based on the incredible true story, Wallenberg, a hero story. He defied the Nazis and faced death to lead 100,000 people to freedom. He sacrificed everything in the name of love. Wallenberg, a hero story, tonight.
Sailor of the Century is a Red Grundy production.